guide you when it's time for your cue to go to Mass. Just as they are sitting you down, it will be the same way you will be released. Everyone will be asked to go out of this door, these side doors, whether you receive communion or not. You can just receive a blessing on the way out. No restrooms available. And as you go out, if you park, if you're sitting on this side, we'll park on that side. We ask you to please go to the back to get to your vehicle. We want to keep the front clear as much as possible so people don't accumulate the front, because we'll be distributing communion, and we want to keep that sacred up there where there's not a lot of congestion. Also, once again, it will be sanitized and laid on the outside before you come back in. During the sign of peace, we ask you to just wave or a nice bow to your people around you. But if you're family, you can shake hands, give hugs as you wish. But anyone else, please refrain from making any kind of contact. Also, there's offertory boxes at the back and communion. If you haven't put your offertory in, we ask you to just go ahead and next week, wait till next week, because we don't want you to go back to the front again. And there will be distributing communion after Mass for 15 minutes from 11:45 to about 12 o'clock. So those of you that are online watching and following us, you have that time to come. And we just ask you to please be patient, and we continue this process as long as we can. And we thank you for your cooperation so far. Thank you. God bless.
Yeah. Thank you. Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los romanos. Hermanos, no tengan duda con nadie. Solamente el amor se lo llevará unos a otros. Pues el que ama al prójimo ha cumplido con toda la ley. En efecto, no cometas adulterio, no mates, no robes, no tengas envidia. Y todos los otros mandamientos se resumen en esta frase: amarás a tu prójimo como a ti mismo. Con el amor no se hace ni un mal al prójimo. Por esto, en el amor cabe toda la ley. Palabra de Dios.
Trained people, she used my shortcut and hers. And eventually,
eventually down the road we had someone else do some training who had their shortcuts. They say, you know, I wasn't selling sandwiches, I was selling shoes. Because it all got changed. Well, the church doesn't do that. The church has what's bound, we're bound by. These readings are about folks who are having some problems. And the responsibility of the community of Christians. Yeah. If you find someone that has a problem, or you know one that knows someone who has a problem, we don't need the whole community running out there to tell them what they're doing. We'd be pointing fingers at everybody. So what they say is, I tell you, come tell your pastor. Come tell someone in charge in the church. So that you can pray about it and see if you want to go talk to them. Who's going to go talk to them? If that doesn't work, take two or three more people. People that are busy in the church, teachers, etc. And see if you can persuade them. If you can't, then the church goes and says, this is what we teach. This is who we are. This is what our community is. Community doesn't change on the whims of someone's ideas of what they think it should do. The church has its teachings. He also is telling us the fact is that we need to go do these things because we hear a lot of folks that do things that are sort of strange. We see people teaching in our schools. We see people on TV that have all kinds of ideas of what we should be as a country. I don't know, but I don't agree with a lot of them. But to be silent about it is to agree with them. You can speak out. Speak out at the boat. Speak out however you want to speak out to your friends. But to be silent with things means you're in agreement. That's what he tells us here. You will be responsible for what happens to us, to our church, to our community. Paul's telling us about love. That there's all sorts of things that we have. We have adultery, not to kill, not to steal, not to covet. Okay? That's the law. He tells us that love covers all that up. That comes to us as a good Samaritan. That was an enemy that he helped. Because he cared for him. We are responsible not to harm anyone by the actions that we do. If we gossip about someone, does that hurt them? If we talk about somebody behind their back, does that hurt them? If the things that we do to them, does that hurt them? We can't do it. We look at everyone in the community, whoever it is, with love. We cannot do anything to harm them or that will cause them harm. There was a story about a woman in gossip. About something going on in the family. She left town. Came back 10 years later. What happened to Betty Jo? She killed herself. Oh, what about her husband? Oh, he's a drunk. What about her children? Well, they ran off from her. What happened? There was a rumor spread about 10 years ago, and this is the result. Sometimes we don't know what we caused or what we said. She didn't. She had no idea what had happened to it. She caused lots of people a lot of harm by what she said. Matthew brings to us the point is that you need to win your brother over. Try telling him. Go through all of these things and you cannot convince them of something different, then they have no input. You're saved, but they have no input into your community. We need to deal with that same way in our families. We can't convince family members to do things the way God intended us to live our lives. Then they have no input. We're constantly trying to do better. Constantly trying to get them to turn over a new leaf at some time in their life. We live in this country today. From what Paul tells us, Christ is telling us, what the Gospels are telling us. Abortion is not love. It's just not love. myself. What I read, what I see, what I watch, what I think, participate in. Do I correct myself? Possible. Very easy to do. One way I can be reconciled back to the life that I'm supposed to live is to come back to the church. Back to what Christ tells me. Come back and reconcile myself with the teachings. Our families fall apart in front of our eyes. Bad is good. Good is bad. We ask the Lord to open our eyes. Let us see. Christ comes to us. We see in a lot of the fishers, and not this one, but it comes like this a lot. When God is standing by that dirt, Christ is standing there, stands out. Sometimes I wonder, maybe he's saying, what are you doing? I can walk by that dead, Lord, I don't know. I need to help. Because I want to come into the open arms of Christ, not the idea that, what am I doing? Come here today to receive Eucharist, to nourish our spirit, to help us be better people. We listen to the word of the Lord. Make us better. Just do better things. Become better people. Do we come prepared? Are we prepared to come to Mass? Or did we come here just because it's a Sunday obligation that I have to go do? Remember, the doors are closed. Christ entered the doors that were closed. So the folks, his hands, his side, oh, he's here. The doors are closed. The Lord appears to us in our minds, in our hearts. In the end, he opens up his arms to us. His sacred heart is open. And we can see the love he has for us.
Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's care, we bring our needs and the needs of our neighbor before the Lord.
For the church, that we may reach out and assist our neighbors in reconciling with God and each other, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For leaders of nations, that they may grow in wisdom, seeking peaceful ways to resolve differences. Others, as they serve the people entrusted to them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those given authority to uphold and enforce the law, that they may respect those they serve and apply the law with justice and compassion, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who work for a living, that they may receive a just wage for their labor. For those who are unemployed or underemployed, that they may not lose heart. pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our beloved Father Lathan, living and deceased, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The dead, especially our departed brothers and sisters, Amelia, known to wait, Rita Guerrero, C.U., and Elvira, Navarrete, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, grant us the will to listen to your voice and the grace to recognize it as we strive to follow you. Hear the prayers we offer and grant them according to your will. Through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At a time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave them to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and confess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
By the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Kingdom, power, and glory. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Please stand. Spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let's pray. Granted that you are faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that you may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of the Almighty God be upon you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.